Welcome to the fifth meeting of Session 6 of the Delegated Powers and Law Reform Committee. Before we move to the first item on the agenda, I'd like to remind everyone present to switch their mobile phones to silent. The first item of business is to decide whether to take item 8 in private. Is the committee content to take item 8 in private? Yeah, thank you. The second item of business is consideration of the instrument laid under the European Union Withdrawal Act 2018. The committee is considering if both the appropriate procedure and categorisation have been applied by the Scottish Government to SSI 2021-297, the Official Controls Transitional Staging Period Miscellaneous Amendments Scotland Regulations 2021. The committee's consideration here only relates to the provision made in Regulation 3 of this instrument. No issues have been raised with either the procedure used by the Scottish Government, in this case the negative procedure, or its categorisation of law. Mr Simpson.
Yes, thanks convener. As you're aware, because you've read this, deals with where checks can be made on animals, and it's, it essentially says that this would allow checks to be carried out on animals and related products at an appropriate place rather than at present at the place of destination of the goods. Now, you know that all sounds not too controversial, but we've had information provided to us from Spice, which says that no reason has been provided as to why that should be the case. And they also go on to say that there's been some concern from stakeholders around this. So given that, I think what we should do is flag this up to the lead committee, which I believe is the Rural Affairs Committee, although they have a slightly longer title than that. Just to make sure that they are casting their eye on this, it does seem to raise important policy matters, which is not for us to consider, but they may want to have a look at it. I realise that the negative procedure is the correct procedure, but it clearly does raise important issues.
Okay, thank you for that, Mr Simpson. So, is the committee content that the appropriate scrutiny procedure has been applied to this instrument, and that it has also been properly categorised as of low significance?
Yes.
Yeah. And secondly, we will also be reporting to the Rural Affairs, Islands and Natural Environment Committee about this instrument, and with that we will highlight the points raised by Spice to them. Is everyone content with that too?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Under agenda item number 3, we are considering instruments subject to the made affirmative procedure. No issues have been raised on SSIs 2021-307 and 319. Is the committee content with these instruments? Under agenda item number 4, we're considering instruments subject to the affirmative procedure. No points have been raised on the following draft instruments. The Disability Assistance for Children and Young People Scotland Amendment Regulations 2021. The Representation of the People Postal Voting for Local Government Elections Scotland Amendment Regulations 2021. And the Scottish Local Government Elections Amendment Order 2021. Is the committee content with these instruments? Under agenda item number 5, we are considering instruments subject to the negative procedure. No points have been raised on SSIs 2021, 297, 305, 310, 312, 313 and 318. Is the committee content with these instruments?
Yep.
Under agenda item number 6, we are considering instruments not subject to any parliamentary procedure. And no points have been raised on SSIs 2021, 303, 304, 308, 309, 311 and 315. Is the committee content with these instruments?
Yes.
Under agenda item number 7, we are considering two documents subject to approval. No points have been raised on SG 2021-229, which is the Code of Conduct for Councillors, and SG 2021-230, the Model Code of Conduct for Members of Devolved Public Bodies. Is the committee content with these documents?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. And with that, I'll move the committee into private.